Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem on Otto cycle. Here is the question. Now whatever is given in this question, I'll write that in the form of data first. So let us get started. Now it is given that an air standard Otto cycle, so I'll mention the type of cycle. It is Otto cycle. Has a compression ratio of 6, so R is equal to 6 compression ratio, so I'll add suffix C, R suffix C is equal to 6. The lowest cycle pressure is 0.1 megapascal, so lowest cycle pressure is P1 and that is equal to 0.1 megapascal. It means 0.1 into 10 raised to 6 pascal is Newton per meter square. So here is the conversion of megapascal into Newton per meter square, and operates between the temperature limits of 27 degrees Celsius and 1569 degrees Celsius. So the temperature limits are T1 initial temperature 27 degrees Celsius. To convert it into Kelvin, I'll add 273. So therefore T1 will become 300 Kelvin. Next, the other temperature which is given 1569 degrees Celsius, it is the maximum temperature in the cycle, and for Otto cycle the maximum temperature is T3, so it is 1569 degrees Celsius, so that will become 1569 plus 273, so therefore T3 comes out to be 1842 Kelvin. And now the question is to calculate the temperature and pressure after isentropic expansion. So after isentropic expansion, the temperature will be T4 and the pressure will be P4. So this is the first question. And next, cycle efficiency means we have to calculate the efficiency of Otto cycle. So this is the data. Now with the data understood, let us try to get the solution to this problem. In the solution part, first I'll draw PV and TS diagram for Otto cycle. Now PV diagram and TS diagram is the pressure, volume and temperature entropy diagram. PV is pressure, volume. TS is temperature entropy diagram. Now the first process in case of Otto cycle is isentropic compression, which is reversible adiabatic, and for that here the process follows a curve from point 1 to point 2, and it is reversible adiabatic or isentropic compression, wherein the volume is V1 at start and at the end the volume is V2, then pressure is P1 at the start, at the end the pressure is P2. So we see that during compression process the volume decreases from V1 to V2, but pressure increases from P1 to P2. So this completes the adiabatic process. Next, from process 2 to 3 it is constant volume heat addition. Heat will be added at constant volume from 2 to 3. So volume at point 2 and volume at point 3 both are same. Next, the process 3 to 4 it will be reversible adiabatic or isentropic expansion. So process 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion process, wherein the volume increases from V3 to V4, and the volume increases but pressure drops from P3 to P4. So we can understand from this graph that during expansion the pressure drops and there is increase in volume. Next, after expansion process from 4 to 1 it is constant volume heat rejection, so V1 is equal to V4, heat is rejected. So here I can say this is the heat rejection process. 2 to 3 was heat addition process QA. Then the curve 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, they follow the law PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Now, once I have completed the PV diagram, next is the TS diagram. Process 1 to 2 is reversible adiabatic compression, which can be shown on TS diagram with a vertical line. So, isentropic compression, wherein the entropy remains constant, that is S1 is equal to S2. Next, constant volume heat addition, it will be shown on a constant volume line. So, here, volume will remain constant, but temperature will go on increasing as this is the heat addition process. Then process 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion, wherein again the entropy will remain constant, but there will be drop in temperature from 0.3 to 0.4. So here we have S3 is equal to S4, the entropy is constant but temperature drops. So we get work output from here. Next, from process 4 to 1, it is constant volume heat rejection. So the volume line is constant, and here the heat is being rejected from 0.4 to 0.1. So when the heat gets rejected, temperature drops from T4 to T1. 2 to 3 is heat addition process. 4 to 1 is heat rejection process. 1 to 2 is the work done in compression process. 3 to 4 is the work which we are getting during the expansion process. So here is the PV and TS diagram for Otto cycle. If I look into the question, the first thing is they are telling us to calculate the temperature and pressure after isentropic expansion. So if I see in the diagram, isentropic expansion is from 3 to 4. Expansion starts from 3, ends at 4. So I have to find out how much is the pressure at this point 4. Similarly, here on TS diagram, expansion is from 3 to 4. I have to calculate how much is the temperature after expansion, that is at point number 4. So T4 and P4 are the unknown values. So I'll start with the calculation from here. I'll say that first of all, for process 1 to 2, which is reversible isentropic process. Now for this process, I can write the relation as T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 raised to gamma minus 1. V1 by V2 is nothing but RC, that is the compression ratio. So I'll write down where R suffix C is called as compression ratio, and that is equal to V1 by V2. Now if I look into the question, compression ratio is given as 6. So therefore T2 by T1 will be equal to compression ratio 6 raised to 1.4 minus 1, because since the working medium is air, we can assume gamma as 1.4. So I'll write down, assuming gamma is equal to 1.4 for air. Now therefore T2 will be equal to, this T1 value is given in the problem as 300 Kelvin. So 300 into 6 raised to 1.4 minus 1. On calculating this, I'll get the answer of T2 as, it comes out to be the value which I have. It is 614.4 Kelvin. So here I have got the value of T2. Next, after getting the value of T2, I'll calculate the value of P2. So now, once we have T2 value, this was for process 1 to 2. Now I'll use the second process, which is constant volume heat addition. So for process 2 to 3, which is constant volume heat addition. Now For state 2 and 3, I can write the equation as P2 V2 upon T2 is equal to P3 V3 upon T3. Since it is constant volume process, since volume at point 2 is equal to volume at point 3, V2 is equal to V3, I can cancel them out. So therefore, here if we see, we would be getting P3 is equal to P2 into T3 upon T2. Now I will keep this as equation number 1, because to calculate P3 I require P2 value. So I'll say that therefore P1 V1 raised to gamma is equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma. Now this was for process 1 to 2, that is the reversible adiabatic process. We can write the relation. Now I'll keep it as P2 shift P1 here. So P2 upon P1 will be equal to V1 by V2 complete raised to gamma. V1 by V2 is nothing but R, or we can say R suffix C, compression ratio. Therefore P2 will be P1 into this. P1 would be there on right hand side multiplied. Now P1 is 0.1 into 10 raised to 6. Next RC, this value is 6 raised to gamma, which is 1.4. so therefore P2 value will come out to be the answer which I have. It is 12.3 into 10 raised to 5 newton per meter square, or if I divide this by 10 raised to 5, it becomes 12.3 bar. Now after getting P2, I'll say that therefore put all values in equation number 1. So in equation 1 we have P3 is equal to P2 into T3 upon T2. So therefore P3 is equal to, P2 is 12.3 into 10 raised to 5. Next, T3 value is given in the question. T3 is 1842 Kelvin. 1842 divided by T2, which is 614.4. So from this I'll get the answer of P3, and it comes out to be 36.9 into 10 raised to 5 newton per meter square. Dividing it by 10 raised to 5, I'll get this as 36.9 bar. So after getting the pressure at point 3, now I'll use the next process, which is 3 to 4 for process 3 to 4, which is reversible adiabatic expansion. For this process I'll write down that P3 V3 raised to gamma is equal to P4 V4 raised to gamma, like I had written for process 1 to 2, that was also isentropic. Now process 3 to 4 is also isentropic. So therefore here if I want to calculate P4, I'll keep P4 on one side, shift P3 in the denominator. So P4 by P3 will be V3 by V4 raised to gamma. Now as we see in the PV and TS diagram, V3 is equal to V2 and V4 is equal to V1 raised to gamma. I'll write down, since V1 is equal to V4 and V2 is equal to V3. So therefore P4 is what we have to calculate. P3 we have found out. It is 36.9 × 10⁵ is equal to, now if I say that since RC, that was compression ratio, it was V1 by V2 is equal to 6 given in the problem. So therefore V2 by V1 will become reciprocal, that is 1/6. So instead of V2 by V1, I'll write down 1/6. Gamma is having same value, 1.4. So from this, if I calculate, I'll get my answer of P4 as, it is 3 × 10⁵ Newton per meter square. So this is the first answer for us. Answer number one. Here I have calculated the pressure after expansion. That is, I have calculated the value of P4. Now T4 value is what we require. So I'll write down that for this process 3 to 4, I can use one more relation, that also T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 raised to gamma minus 1. And next V4 is equal to V1, as we know, V3 is equal to V2 raised to gamma minus 1, since V1 is equal to V2. Since V1 is equal to V4 and V2 is equal to V3, because both are constant volume processes. So therefore T3 by T4 will become, V1 by V2 is RC, I can write down, because compression ratio, in this problem nothing is said about the different values of compression ratio and expansion ratio, so we can take the same ratio. So therefore T3 is given in the question. T3 is 1842 Kelvin. So 1842 upon T4. RC is 6, gamma 1.4. So from this I'll get T4 is equal to 1842 upon this term, 6 raised to 1.4 minus 1. So from this I'll get the answer of T4, and it comes out to be 900 Kelvin. So this is the second answer which we are getting. So now if we see that we have calculated the temperature also, T4, so temperature and pressure after isentropic expansion, T4 and P4 have been calculated. Now the last thing, that is efficiency of Otto cycle, is what is left. So after this I'll say that since efficiency of Otto cycle is given by 1 minus 1 upon RC raised to gamma minus 1, this is the formula. So therefore the efficiency of Otto cycle will be equal to 1 minus 1 upon RC is given as, it is given in the problem as 6, so 6 raised to 1.4 minus 1. So from this the efficiency of Otto cycle on calculation, it comes out to be 0.5116, or if I multiply it by 100, the answer comes out to be 51.16%, and this is the third answer. So if we look into this question, here we have calculated the temperature and pressure value after the expansion process T4 and P4, and even the value of efficiency of Otto cycle, that is the cycle efficiency, as 51.16%, and with this we complete the problem.